When it comes to graduations, it's a big deal for seniors and their families. But right now, the University of Minnesota is again making headlines for its graduation plans that might have students not walking across the stage next spring. Here's Kent.
Walking is a bit of a rite of passage for any student who takes classes on a campus as large as the University of Minnesota's, which is why a proposed plan to do away with walking for upcoming graduations stopped senior Akira Terry in her tracks.
I shouldn't have to fight for a graduation that I earned, so yeah, it's been stressful.
The stress began on Monday.
By now, many of you may be aware.
When she received an email from the dean of the College of Liberal Arts saying graduation for several colleges would likely be combined inside the football stadium due to renovations at Mariucci Arena. And when she replied with questions about the ceremony itself,
thank you for taking time to share your concerns.
She received this message from a commencement planning member saying, due to the expected size of the graduating class, students will not walk across the stage to receive their diplomas, adding, names will not be announced at the ceremony either.
We worked so hard. The pandemic put a toll on everybody, like mentally and physically. A lot of people went through things, and so we still pushed through and still worked hard to get to this moment. It just feels a little unfair.
And she was not the only one who felt that way.
It would hurt if we didn't get the opportunity to finish it off strong and normal.
Senior Olivia Zatkowski started a walking petition on change.org, which received more than 7,000 online signatures in just a few days.
What does that tell you?
It just shows that it means a lot to a lot of students, a lot of parents, friends, family, everyone who's looking forward to see us walk across the stage and get the recognition. So it's nice to see that other people have had the same thoughts that I had.
It's even nicer when it's noticed. This morning, the U of M's executive vice president and provost sent another email saying, we hear your disappointment, and we are committed to developing plans that will allow our spring 2023 graduates to be individually recognized. You have worked hard for this moment and have overcome so many challenges in your collegiate career.
I am glad that the university acknowledged the petition.
What did you learn through this process?
It really just goes to show that if there's something that enough people care about, you can actually get the university or whoever it is to take notice.
We made a difference in a big way because I think they were just gonna sweep it under the rug and keep it going and not expect people to say anything. I hope they'll listen to their students and do what's right and actually give us a graduation. But for me personally, I do have a good family support who is like, well, regardless, you will get a graduation even if we have to build a whole podium and stage and call your name that way. So I'm trying to keep positive.
Have you heard anything personally from the university?
I have not, no. I don't anticipate it, I don't expect it. I just want to see the change happen from it. I just want to see that this will actually fix the issue that people are having.
I did reach out to the university for comment today in hopes of trying to find out what options might be on the table for graduation outside of Huntington Bank Stadium. Instead, they direct me back to that email to students, which simply asks for patience as they try to sort all of this out. In Minneapolis, Kent Erdahl, KARE 11 News.